So, good afternoon. Good afternoon to all, and I welcome you, all of you, for the session named as a Super Learner course. The very good aim of the Super Learner course is to give you the idea about what are the learning techniques, worldwide learning techniques are available, so that students can know all those things and how to face the exam, how to stop forgetting. How to stop forgetting, how to increase our memory power. Such a things I am going to cover in this session. Name it as a Super Learner course. It's not only for the graduates, it can be used for the schools also, school level also. Ordinary people also can use this methodology. All are world-proven methodology. Experts are suggested nominated techniques. Okay, what happens when we study? Why forgetting happens? What are the remedies are there? Such a things we are going to discuss. Definitely you will enjoy a lot because this session is entirely different from traditional other presentation. Okay, I'm Dr. Suresh. So what is my aim in the sense? To teach you the techniques to set your study goals, exploring methods to develop photographic memory, illustrating the points to remember all that you studied, explore the world's best proven study practices, eliminate exam fear, and utilize your time effectively, and increase your super confidence. So as Vivekananda said, every child is talented. We have to just unlock. So this session, I am here just to unlock your talent. So once if you know all the technique, then definitely you can adapt it to yourself, and definitely you will become great. So this is what the outcome expected for my session, Super Learner course. So after the session, you come to know about what are the world's best reading techniques are there, why forgetting happens, and how to overcome that. Then what happens when we read? Then how to face the exam? Such a things we are going to get the idea about all those things. So know to utilize students' time effectively, enjoy studies with the super confidence, understand the world's best proven study practices. So actually, my session consists of four parts. One is memory, revision and exam techniques, best learning techniques, how to face the exam, and so on. Okay, so it is divided into four parts. I will cover everything. First, let us see about memory. What is a memory and how it degrades? When you learn something, what really happens? What really happens? How forgetting happens? What is the memory power? Such a thing. See, this curve, Ebbinghaus forgetting curve shows you that how the curve gets degrades. Once if you memorize, you can see that the retention level is keep decreasing to 20 minutes, 1 hour, 9 hours, and at some point you can see here. So 100% to it goes to some 20%. Memory is a very important part of learning, but unfortunately retention is keep degrading as shown in this curve. So 80% of what you learn today will be forgotten within 24 hours if you don't make a conscious effort to remember it. So what you need to do is, in a regular interval, you have to review it. So this is what really some things we are having the short thing. Say some of the frequent names, friends, father, mother, such important things we ever forgive, no? That they ever forget, no? The reason is you keep review that. But however, there's a thing, examination syllabus or some other exams, theory exams, some practical exams. What you need to do is you didn't review in a regular interval. That is the reason for forgetting. This is what really they are telling. So in a regular interval, you should keep a review so that it will be retained in your mind. So let us discuss how we can do. Effective revision is an ongoing process. Effective revision is a very good recommended practice or review practice that keep your retention level good. See, this diagram give you an idea about how you can keep remember. It gives a quick gist. New information goes to short-term memory, because we are having short-term memory, long-term memory. Small capacity, chunk and rigors, encode the information selectively or actively. Selectively, in the sense active reading is there, then the passive reading is there. We will discuss it. So it makes association. If you make it association, then with the prior knowledge, it stores in the long-term memory store. And if you take breaks or regular reviews, what you can do is you can remember. So revision, review is very important thing. So what is the very important thing for retention, in the sense people say, experts say, association is very important. Association in the sense, whatever you read newly, that should be linked, associated with the existing knowledge. That's what they are telling, association. Try to link new information into your brain with something you already know, which makes your retention level very good, right? So it should be organized. Whatever you read, it should be organized, revised, reviewed in a regular interval. That is very important for forget. Okay. Review. Review should be an active attempt to hook the facts into your visual, auditory, and kinesthetic memory. Kinesthetic memory, because that people, depending upon the people, they may different type of study capability. One people may use visual cues, visually everything is given, then they used to read it that in good manner. Some people auditory, right? Audio, right? They hear from tape and something, and they are having that sort of memory. Kinesthetic memory also a type of memory. Students, you use that methodology also. We will discuss this. Mind maps can be particularly useful as they present information in a visual form. So let us discuss about how that retention peak falls, and review how keeps the retention in a good way. See, look at this. 10 minutes later, start reviewing. 1 day later, start reviewing. 1 week later, start reviewing. 1 month later, you should know it. So at one time, if you are studying and you are telling that I forget, sir, not works, in the sense, that's not good. You have to do this much of times. So review in a regular interval. Practice you should do so that your mind retention will be good. Review engraves the learning deeper and deeper in your mind. Rework and condense the material. So this is what here is shown, so that you can recall 6 months later too. So whenever you read, say for an example, 1 hour you are reading, in the sense a 10 minutes break is needed, because the memory has to do all the retention activity. Taking break for 10 minutes in 1 hour and 50 minutes of study will be helpful. So make your preferences work for you. So three sort of learners are there. One is a visual learner. As I told you, they use visual images, make mind maps, and so on, color code, such a thing, using digital camera as a visual notebook, such a thing. They study in their own way. Auditory learner, use your digital voice recorder, music, read aloud, or use text speech. This is what we do in a school, right? So this is auditory learning type. And another one is kinesthetic learner. It is the type of act things out, move around, write over again. That's what a writing, record note and listen on the move. This is said to be the kinesthetic learner. Make your preferences work for you. So if you think of yourself as visuals, so you can do like make big posters and colorful charts, put these up all around your space and look at them often, make mind maps. Sometimes some of the people already made all these things and they sell. You can purchase that for competitive exams, GATE exams, or any TNPSC exam. Whatever the exams may be, right? Some already built color images are available. Images, prepared well, material is available. You can use that. The second method, listening. What you can do is you can record your learning materials or revision notes on your digital voice recorder, and you can keep asking that. This is one sort of methodology for learning. Why? Because it works, because this is how he is familiar. His or her system also works. Read aloud to yourself or use a text-to-speech software. You can use music as an aid in this case. Then if you prefer to learn by doing in the sense, I can simply say Wikipedia, suppose you are reading, right? Wikipedia, you are editing the content. That can be right or wrong, so you are editing. This is the two thing that Wikipedia editing is a very good example for learn by doing, or project is a very good example for learning by doing. Okay, theoretical study, not a theoretical study. Practically, you are illustrating, you are implementing, and learn from that. That's what learn by doing. So in this case, what you can do is you can write your notes repeatedly without just copying. You have to get involved in this. Expert says making links. Our memory works by building links. So we remember things which are associated in our mind by repetition, sense, color, rhythm, rhyme, or anything which is unique or unusual, absurd or unusual. See, here you can see like how to make a link. See, this is what he has, one mind map is made up of. This is by Robert Feynman, that the scientist have made this sort of method. So whatever you read, it should be organized and it should be a mind map. So, sir, I don't have time enough to do these sort of things. There are people are there who have made their study material very easy, centers, and they are providing. You can buy it and you can use it, right? So you need not to afraid of. See, look at this, how he had made a map, making links with one another, exam toolkit, exam gap, time, equipment. So you can see this, how they have made it. Okay. So when you think of exam, most of the people get afraid of exam. Even if you say like, sir, I'm not afraid of exam, I'm a graduate, I can do this. Even if you say so, if they go for a competitive exam, they get fear. Sometimes you use it to say, sir, I forget, sir. Because no time I lost, I forget what I studied. This is what they say. So let us first of all know about what is exam. Examination tend to be about what you understand more than what you can remember. Say for an example, you have studied a plenty of things, but you need not to write everything. Just you need to answer what is the question is raised. Okay, this is what aim of the exam. If you revise effectively throughout the year and before the exam and have a good understanding of the subject, then you have the potential to do well. As far as the exam is concerned, positive mental attitude is very important. Then reviewing your work throughout the year is needed. If not, you still need to allow plenty of time to revise, at least 6 to 8 weeks. You need to keep revise so that you can easily, your retention level increased and you can remember. You will need to get organized and start your revision well in advance of the exam start date. Very, very important thing is avoid last minute panic and cramming. Last minute mug up won't work. This is what most of the engineers do. Engineering graduate students do. They refer the book before the examination overnight and they write something and they say like, I have a poor memory and so on. So this is what world renowned techniques, everyone do, every experts do, good students do. So you should adapt it to this. So revision strategies, there are plenty of revision strategies, reading strategies, studying strategies are there. What you can do is you can follow these things. In a very simplest manner, what I can tell you is break down your subjects into topics. All night marathons are not a way to revise. So what you need to do is you can make a flow. You can organize. And you have to start work on it. Reworking and condensing your notes will be the helpful tool. Reworking and condensing. You can take a notes also. Or otherwise, as I said, some of the people have already implemented that you can get it. Google is the best place where you can get everything in this world as of now, right? Revise everything more than once. So only one time if you mug up, that is overnight mug up, right? Then if you come and write, then that won't work. Very simplest example is Max is a very good example. If you study everything in overnight Max and try to come for next day and write exam, nothing will be remembered. You should work out, right? In a regular interval, you should practice. The same thing should be adapted for theory examination also. Revise everything more than once. Overlearning is important for retention. So this is a formula. Next, try explaining your topic to someone who does not know anything about it. This is one of the methods we are going to discuss it. Practice writing under timed conditions. Writing under timed conditions. And be realistic about how much you can produce in the given time. So look, cover, write, check. This is abstractly I'm telling. So old and trusted technique that still works for many people is revise a section of work, cover it up and put it aside, write down or record as much as you can remember, check against the original, highlight anything you got wrong or forget, prioritize the areas for future revision. There is no fixed methodology. You should know all the methodology that's all adapted by all over the world, and whichever you feel good to you, what you can do is you can adapt. So I don't recommend anything to you. I am recommending these are all the methods people using. So try to learn all these methods, and whatever your mind says, you follow that. Past question paper, this is very important. Certain questions are repeatedly used. I can remember my 12th standard. One of my physics master simply said, like, from the past question paper, he said one thing. This question they used to ask last 2 years. So definitely it won't come this year. But unfortunately, that question, same 10 mark question they asked. So you are not sure about whether they are asking or not. If you are using your past question papers, that is very helpful, or related questions they will ask. Questions can be repeated. Around 60% of the questions are repeated, not only for engineering examination, school examination, competitive examination, all examination, this is true. So past papers may also act as a guide to the types of topic which crop up in the exam, but don't rely on this too much. But I recommend rely on this too much, but you should be concentrate on other part of the syllabus also. Plan in your exam in advance. This is a very good thing. Plan your exams in advance. So the exam time, if you are planned, nothing will work. You should be get ready about a blueprint of the examination question paper. And you should practice, keep practice. Mentally, you should prepare yourself very good for the last examination. That is a university examination or state board examination or final examination, whatever it may be. Okay, plan your exam time in advance. You should write n number of times within that given time unit. Generally 3 hours, no, that can be, you can take, and you can mentally prepare yourself. Take your watch off and place it on the desk, because it gives you the time, that's all. So when you read, what you can do is something which you feel good can be underlined, can be boxed, right? And frequently come across formulas or points that can be underlined. Give plenty of explanation and examples for whatever you read so that you can easily recall. Examiners can only give you credit for what you actually write. They don't assume any knowledge. So how to overcome the pre-examination stress, in the sense having good sleep is must. And something, fruit juice, you can go ahead instead of coffee or some other thing. Then you can have a bath. Priorly, you can go to the exam hall and so on. Think of all the things you can do, not all the things you cannot. Think positively. Allow yourself time for rest and recreation. Okay, so what I have told you is I have given the abstract idea about the exam, some of the study methodology, what is retention curve and so on. Now I am going to tell you about some of around 13 world proven learning techniques. I am going to tell you knowingly, unknowingly, you also know all the learning techniques. Whichever you feel comfortable, you can adapt. What the research says in the sense, daily we are grasping the information around 174 newspapers a day in this age, but organized information and knowledge missing. Okay, in the digital era we are getting this much of information, but organized, but knowledge wise, knowledge from information knowledge comes. That knowledge, if you take, that's not comes. Why? Because we are not doing effective study. As a result, we fool ourselves into thinking that we are learning and growing. We develop fake confidence based on the information we cannot even recall. So you should first of all know about the two important things. One is passive learning and another one is active learning. In the learning, two things is there. One is passive learning and another one is active learning. Passive learning, if you take Wikipedia, right, if you give the URL, then Wikipedia comes and you start reading. This is a passive learning, right? Mentally you are reading. Editing Wikipedia, suppose you are writing a page, or the page is given, you want to change something, some words. What the scientists have identified in the sense, this is said to be the active learning. It has highest impact than the passive learning. This passive learning, they tell, this type of learning is also the worst because it dramatically reduces the comprehension, that is understandability. Okay, what is active learning? Active learning is a form of learning where the learner actively participates to learn and get real-time feedback. See, look at this. Actually, these three sort of learning they have given, but the retention level also they have given. Receiving, merely receiving, that's what the passive learning. Audio visual reading lecture is 20% retention, lesser than 20%. Participating is the intermediary level between learning by doing and passive learning. What is learning by doing? Project is a very good example, or practical is a very good example for learning by doing. You are really doing, you are trying to implement everything, right? In real world, you are doing everything on your own. So participating, play, exercise, discussion, demonstration is said to be the participating, which is gives 20% to 75%. Learning by doing greater than 75%. So active learning requires engagement. See, learning by doing, to work with the coach, immediate practicing. So we are going to now discuss from this active and passive learning, we are going to discuss 30 learning methods, world-proven learning methods. One is well-known Richard Feynman technique. Brainstorming, note-taking, recalling, practicing, reflecting, such a things we are going to discuss. So before we go to this, we should first of all know one of this terminology. What is experiential learning? Kids know. Kids used to do experiential learning. In childhood, we used to do everything in term of experience. Say for an example, fire is there. Child will go and touch the fire and understand, oh, it's hot. Okay, we should not touch. It is harmful to us. In this way, it understands. No, that's what's to do with the experiential learning. This is what they have given. Experiential learning. What is experiential learning? Is a form of learning where the learner learns by doing and reflecting upon their performance. So they have given all these things. Okay, look at this. See, look at this. Active experimentation, concrete experience, reflecting assertion, abstract conceptualization, and so on. David Kolff introduced this model of experimental learning cycle as this follows. It's a natural form of learning because this is how kids learned. Let us see what are the 13 world-proof techniques are there. First one, highlighting and annotating. Whenever you read, what you need to do is you should highlight certain words, and the highlighter you can use. So that's one of the method of reading. You can see this. Some of the students, some faculties, or some people used to do this. This is how you may also study. Reflecting and questioning. When you study, you can ask another question, 2-mark question, 6-mark question, or from this one you can ask another question and try to learn from the Google, right? That's what said to be the reflecting and questioning. What if, how can I, why? This is one of the studying methodology. Brainstorming and ideating. Brainstorming in the sense more than one student, the learner, reader, what they can do is they can join with one another and they can keep studying. They can keep studying. That's what brainstorming and ideating. So you may also create mind maps of the information you learn to ideate or distill everything down to the important takeaways. Okay, the fourth methodology is the tracking and game-based learning. Some things you can choose in a game-based learning. Let me tell you, game-based learning. Towers of Hanoi problem, you would have studied in the first year. Towers of Hanoi problem. That is three poles are there, four disc, small to big discs are there. You have to use one of the pole as the intermediary pole, and you have to move from all the disc from one pole to another pole, provided such that it should be ascending order. Ascending order in a descending order, right? That is a game-based learning. A very good example for game-based learning. So a lot of game-based learnings are there. So either you can go with game-based learning also. That's what the tracking and the game-based learning. The Feynman technique. This is a world-proven methodology, well-known methodology. It's very simple. Pick a topic and study it. Explain it to someone unfamiliar with the topic in a simple language. Identify the gaps in your understanding when you fail to explain. Study the gaps again to understand better. Rinse and repeat until you grasp the topic very well. This is very simple. I am telling you this super learner course. This super learner course, what you are doing, you are getting the idea, right? But you don't have the idea about super learner course. I am learned the super learner course, created a super learner course, and I am giving to you. So from you, I can get you the feedback such that what are the things are all missing. So that once again, I can read it once again, and I can next time I can give you the very good presentation and so on. This is what the Feynman technique is there. So if you take a subject, learn the particular topic, ask some other people, you try to explain. That can be some kid or your mother or your friend or something. You try to explain. So if he don't understand and he can ask you the question, you pick up once again, you try to read and try to explain. Discussing and peer reviewing. So this is what 4 or 5 students you have to sit and you have to discuss with each other. This is generally happens now. Suppose you are not a very good, you are not studied very good. You will go to the person who study very well. 4 or 5 students go and approach, and you can ask them, hey, explain what you studied so that we can write the exam. He will explain whatever he studied. And you can add some point. Another guy can add some point. This is said to be the discussing and peer reviewing. Reviewing. This is also one type of learning method. Hiring a coach and deliberate practicing. This methodology involves you have to hire for money a coach, particularly for very important exams, hard exams, max or some other thing. You can use that. So hire a coach and you try to explain, read it out and say everything. The coach will give you the quick guidelines about what is correct, what is wrong, and he will correct you and you can adapt it. Next, experiential learning is about getting out there in the real world and adapt the technique. A lot of times you need wisdom from your own experiences that you can get from reading books or listening to someone lecturing you. Next, repeated exposure is another one of the method. Due to the complexity of the topic or the passion you have for it, you may want to learn more about the topic no matter how much you learn. For those repeated exposure from different perspective is the best way to learn and expand your knowledge. Repeated exposure. Just-in-time learning. Very simplest example is, say for an example, suppose you need to revise, revise or want to get the knowledge about a certain topic. Say for an example, yoga. So what you do, you will open the Google and you will search for lecture notes on yoga and you read it and save all the materials altogether. Then later on, you will plan to study. So this is just in time learning. In this way also you can learn. Instead of, right? Just in time learning is about learning the topics that are relevant at the current time in your life. For example, if you are starting a business, you would learn a ton about it in that phase of your life. Interleaving technique. This is also a brilliant methodology. What this interleaving technique says, in the sense, suppose you are interested to study for 1 hour, then for 20 minutes, one subject, one topic, another 20 minutes, another subject or another topic, the third 20 minutes, the same thing, fourth 20 minutes, fifth 20 minutes, you can study another thing. This is also one of the study methodology that works. We used to do. Interleaving technique is about learning multiple topics simultaneously. It will not only help you cover many subjects at once, but you will be able to connect different ideas from various disciplines while getting more creative as you build strong pathways in your brain. 12th technique is active recalling. This methodology is very interesting. In childhood, how we used to study, suppose a book is there, we keep study. Recalling. We study and we recite ourselves until short-term memory to long-term memory. Active recall is a method that helps you memorize a topic by transferring the information from the short-term memory to the long-term memory. The best system to practice it is the spaced repetition system. Okay, so this is what is said to be the active recalling. See, flashcards can be used for this kind of active recalling. Flashcard, in the sense, suppose you have to have the most frequently used words in a card. Similarly, you can have 10 cards, 20 cards, 30 cards. So using that card, you try to recall what is the definition for that. So that's what a flashcards active recalling methodology. There are software also available which you can use it for studying. Testing and evaluating yourself. The last piece of this learning is, the last piece of puzzle is to test yourself. It has a unique value that you cannot get from simply learning or practicing. You need discipline and courage to admit what you don't understand or what you find hard to do. Ignoring those things would be one of the worst mistakes a learner can make, because you need to have a strong foundation before you move on to an advanced level. So this is the summarized version of world most proven learning methodologies: elaboration, integration, self-explanation, summarization, highlighting, underlining, keyword mnemonic, imagery for text, rereading, practice testing, distributed practices, interleaved practices. So these are all some of the well-known techniques. You should know all the techniques, and your mind will tell you which technique is most useful to you. Don't force your system to select the appropriate method to do that. Just enjoy, and your mind will tell you, let us go for this one. Now, after we discussed two methodology, let us go and discuss how to prevent forgetting. So that the information should not forget, and it should be, retention should be high. So we should have a very good memory. So how we can have a memory? So this is what we are going to discuss now, how to prevent forgetting. So first of all, you should know the curve. The curve will show you about how that forgetting happens. So once if you come to know about how forgetting happens, you can overcome forgetting and you can increase your retention. Curve of forgetting. See, you can see from this picture that what happens when you read it. See, first time,
at September 30, you study, right? After 30 minutes, you studied. Next day, 15 minutes, you are reviewing. 1 week, 1 week later, 10 minutes, you are reviewing. You can see, like, after 1 month, still the forgetting, that retention curve is good. But however, the memory rate, you can see, like, it's poor when you forget to review in a regular interval. So what it teaches in the sense, it teaches secrets of success is consistency of purpose. So you should, in a regular interval, you should review what you are interested. So intention to remember, tell the brain that you are interested with the certain contents, and it keeps put in the, keep put in this mind. Okay. Remembering will request that you want to remember. If you have not made a decision to remember what you are reading, studying, you will forget almost immediately. For this, you need to have certain things, the place, your motivation, interest. These are all very important thing for intention to remember. And another thing regarding that forgetting is, don't overload your memory. So that's what this diagram says. Don't overload your memory. Memory prefers to have only 3, 4, or 5 things at one time. 4 or 5 items in a group into smaller bites. Understand before you try to remember. If you don't understand something, your memory will have difficulty storing it. That's what experts says. You should have a very good understanding whatever you study. Once if you understood in your lifelong, you ever forget. That's right. So that's what regarding that forgetting. Select the most interesting point in that particular reading. In reading, what is the most interesting point is? So just grab it. Organize the material to be learned. This is very important. If you read in a nilly-willy manner, nothing will be in your mind, right? So what you need to do is, you need to organize, prioritize, organize, right? Whatever the subject can be. The material can be in a different way. Generally, whatever the material they are giving is organized only. But even what you can do is, you can further reorganize. So that's what they are telling. Your memory works best when the information is organized. Organize first. My suggestion is, you cannot organize first read. You keep read. Your mind will say, this is what the order. At the time, you can start doing that. First time, you gently have a look at. Relate the ideas to what you already know. This is what making a link between, association between what you already know. So your memory have a very good memory when you do this sort of association. Test yourself repeatedly. That's what very important. In a regular interval, you try to repeat. In a regular interval, you try to repeat, review yourself. That is really very helpful to avoid the forgetting. So you can use the mnemonic devices. Say for an example, what you can do is, a sentence is there. What you can do is, you can take the first letter of the sentence and make a new word, mnemonic, and you can use that. Suppose that is very hard to learn in the sense. Right? See, you can use acronym also. Say for an example, certain things are all in ascending order, it should be memorized. Descending order, it should be memorized. You can have that. Previous thing, I forget to say one thing. For this one, what you can do is, you can make that first letter as the mnemonic. So let me tell you a very simplest thing. Don't mistaken by this word. See, blue litmus red in acid. What you can do is, you can take the first letter, because it is always confused. Blue litmus red in acid, or red litmus blue in acid. So you are not very sure that, right? So what you can do is you can take the first letter of this sentence, blue B, blue litmus, red R, red in as it A, B R A, bra, don't forget. Right? This is one of the easiest method to remember. There is another method also, something suppose if you are interested in the sense, these sort of sentences that should be prioritized, then you can take the first letter and you can make the acronym. That is also one of the best way to remember. So let me tell you, suppose if you are second year students, computer science engineering students, then you probably remember about computer networking. In the computer networking, that particular layer, say layers like TCP IP layer, OSI layer, those layers are there. That layers help you. You need to remember those layers. That can easily be remind. Say for an example, please do not take salespeople advice. P, physical layer. Do not. Data link layer. Not network layer. Please do not take transport layer. Please do not take sales session layer. Salespeople advice, physical presentation layer. Next, please do not take salespeople advice, application layer. So this is how you can simply recall by using mnemonic devices, right? See, here also they have given some example. Study before going to bed is the good idea. Study before going to bed also another good idea. And the morning study also really helpful. Secrets to studying, hints on how to pass any exam. So I have covered a plenty of thing. This is also one of the quick gist ideas about how to study well and how to pass any exams. So the same thing, two most important things you need are motivation and an effective study plan. In a regular interval, you have to study in the place where you study regularly. That should be composed, good place. So you can have set the schedule. You can develop a strong, effective study habit, at least 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. If you study 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, full-fledged, you can study. 1 hour break, 1 hour, 1 hour. In this way, you can study. Study shorter, more often. See, this is another good idea. So instead of studying everything in a full-fledged, study shorter, more often. Avoid all distractions. Some people used to do like TV and radio and songs, such a things. I recommend to don't go for that. Avoid all distractions. Play while you play, study while you study. Where to study? Whichever the place you feel comfortable. That one place you should always sit and study. That's a very good idea. So that's what they have given in this right study environment. Don't lie in the bed and study. Nothing will happen. Sit. Your pose is very important to study. Eat light and eat right. Light level you can eat. Take study breaks. Find your peak performance time. This is interesting. Whichever the place you feel good for study, you can identify at some point of time. This time always my mindset works good. So you can choose that time. Next, avoid cramming. Cramming in the sense of overnight study. Before the examination, try to study everything. Nothing will yield good to you. Use study aids to your advantage. Actually, study aids are nowadays available in all stores and centers, and materials are provided. You have to first of all collect that. If you collect, most of the things are all completed. So the same thing, memorization tools, I told you, acrostics, acronyms, and one thing. And another thing is imaging techniques. Suppose you don't understand anything, say for an example, Thirukural, you need to study. Some Sanskrit slogans you need to study. In the sense, what you can do is you can practice yourself by imaging visualization. after this image, this, after this image, this, after this image, this, for each and every word, for the whole sentences. That is also another interesting area that works. So this is also the technique we studied: recitation, interest, repetition. Memory is interest plus repetition. Reading and rereading is helpful, but also say things out loud, write them down, invent acronym or use the linking technique. So the best way to learn is unlearn, learn, unlearn, or learn, unlearn, learn. See what it is: learn, unlearn, learn. Because past is gone, you should forget the past. For the time being, what is most important, you concentrate that, so that you will get a plenty of memory. And this is another interesting thing: visualize your success and damn your fears. You should think as if you are a very good scorer, you are writing an exam in a good manner, you are preparing that for the exam in a good way. So that positive attitude really lead you to for the very good one. Okay, that's what they are telling: visualize your success and damn you for fears. Psychologically prepare yourself for success. Professional athletes frequently use visualization techniques to improve their performance. So it works for you too. You guys also can visualize your success. Don't cram the night before. This is what generally all the engineering students are doing, but that won't work. If you want a very good result, make a habit of studying in a regular interval, reviewing every regular interval. So let us next discuss about how to face the exam. During the exam, what we have to do. Before that, we should understand about other things also. So course material you should get ready, and question paper, past question paper, you should be prepared well. In a regular interval, you have to study well. Create a fair and level playing field. Then another thing is, see, for examination, when you try before the examination, what you need to do is you need to write n number of times, because within 3 hours you have to complete. The time insufficiency is a major cause. So don't plan in the exam. Get the model, blueprint model, and try everything in the practice places itself. Okay, so that is very important. So before going to the exam, that is 6 months before, 1 year before, you have to schedule everything. Or suppose you are writing a examination in the sense, some other competitive examination in the sense, suppose 1 month prior, you should schedule it. This is the time allotted for, this is the time allotted for, this is how I started, this is the time I have to complete, and everything you can pre-plan. So at the beginning of the exam, right, you should mentally be prepared, and don't talk with your peers for 10-15 minutes. Go to the hall very earlier, bring the pencil, paper, instead of 1-2 copy, bring the water bottle, because that water is always a good one for flourishing your mind, brain. So bringing the water is a good one also. Keep an eye on the time, because sometimes when you write the examination, you are very interested in that particular question only and forget about the other questions. That may lead to another thing, in time insufficiency. And another one is, finally, never leave an exam earlier. See, even though you felt like you completed the exam, and till 15 more minutes are there, that 15 more minutes you can try for the exam paper scrutinizing. You can scrutinize once again. And when you read the question paper, make sure what is the action verb they have given: analyze, argue, compare, contrast, criticize, discuss, evaluate, and so on. One times or two times, you should thoroughly read out the entire question paper. Because
when you read it thoroughly, your mind will lay a plan how to answer. Compare and argue is not the same. Compare and analyze is not same with criticize. So you should sure about how that action verbs are given. And consideration, limitations, everything you have to consider. 2-mark question, you need to answer only 2-mark. 4-mark question, you need to answer 4-mark. My recommendation, full page, 1 full page, 4-mark. Half page, 2-mark. 8 page, 2 pages. 2 pages, 8-mark, 2 pages, or maximum 3 pages. 16-mark, around 4 pages, 5 pages is enough. And you need not to write continuously. You can use a spider diagram. Okay. You can use spider diagram, and the presentation carries good marks. So presentation, need presentation also very important thing. They don't put marks for whatever you know. They only put marks for what they have asked the question and what you have answered. So top tips are: arrive early, bring spare pencil, stay positive, read the questions carefully, and study skills, developing revision timetable, setting priorities, alternating between topics, revising with the course mates and materials, practicing your handwriting, very important. If you want to complete your exam within the time, you should try n number of times with the past question paper, reflecting on your understanding of the topic, setting realistic revision goals. This is what really the examiners are like. So don't you need not afraid of about the examination. Correct use of keywords and phrases, questions answered in the correct format, not writing all you know on a topic, discussing course material critically, using time well, neat presentation. Okay, so this is what examiners would like to see from you. Okay, don't write whatever you know, just answer what they have asked the questions. During the last few days before the exam, take care of your body, take care of your mind, and have a quick look over the material you have revised. Take care of your body, take breaks and time to relax and let your brain rest. So what I recommend to you, in the sense, play while you play, study while you study. Increase the priorities for studies, but don't quit playing. Playing, energizing, entertaining is very, very important, because that soothes your mindset and body also. So always keep studying is not a good one. Effective studying is most important. Take breaks and time to relax and let your brain rest. Plan out how to use your time during the exam. Make sure you have all the books, materials, calculator, pens, everything. Arrive early for the exam. Bring spare pens, pencils. Avoid discussing exam with the classmates before. Use relaxation techniques. Stay positive. Take water with you to the exam and sip throughout. This is a well-known technique. Most of the good students used to do this. So I also recommend you. Take your time. Read questions carefully. Budget your time. Don't panic if you see other people finishing before you can. Breathe deeply and slowly. Okay, students, I have completed this Super Learner course, in which I covered the following thing. What is forgetting? How to increase the retention ratio? How to increase your memory? What are the world-proven studying methodology or learning methodology? What is exam? How to face the exam? What are the expectations from the examiners? How you can get ready for the examination? Prior to examination, posteriori to examination, how you can get ready, such a things we discussed. Thank you. Thank you very much.